We have so many bad examples when it comes to the African-American community. A lot of the kids are being raised by single moms, and I didn't want to have that for my son. I wanted to be there and make sure that not only do I show him the responsibilities of a man, but showing him love, compassion, knowing that I love him, I care about them, embracing him, hearing his voice and spending time with him, because that was a lot of things that I was missing as a young kid.
Yeah.
You know, my father was out. A lot of people just need help. Different up and downs was going on with the pandemic. A lot of people losing jobs. A lot of people making more money than just unemployment.
Yeah.
So having a conversation in my city, in my state, Memphis, is just more trust.
Yeah.
You know, they need to feel like they have an environment where somebody's gonna take care of them. They're gonna feel trust. They can trust the environment. Someone's gonna protect them. And they have the ability to make income. The biggest thing of how we're able to take control of that situation, taking control of your finances. That's the biggest thing. And a lot of people, they don't have hope right now. They got these jobs that's not secure. They're getting laid off, or they're getting closed down because COVID reasons. The biggest thing that I tell them, there's hope around the corner.
Never short stopping, now I'm winning like I'm Jada. Steady through the rigor.
So my guest today comes from Compton, California, South Central LA, and now in Memphis, Tennessee. We discovered him at a previous financial services company. At the same time, too, he has a background in selling newspapers at a kiosk, making six figures. And today he is in financial services. So, hey, Musgrove, good to be with you, bro.
Good to be.
All right, bro. So talk to us, man. What made sense for you to even think about coming into financial services? You had some success already selling newspapers, six figures doing that. Mm-hmm. Why even consider financial services?
I was looking for stability. I was in the marketing frame with the newspapers for roughly about 17 years.
Yep.
I was kept on getting the contract counsel with the newspaper. So I realized very fast, you know, I wanted to be in the independent contractor role,
yeah.
But I knew real fast self-employed wasn't stable. So I wanted to be with something where I had ownership, and at the same time, I had flexibility. And I wanted to be around something that was recession-proof, that has been around for a long time. So it just made sense. It made sense.
You were, you know, kind of with, you know, the financial services industry already. What do you think makes the PHP agency platform different?
The environment, leadership. You have a lot of leaders that's engaged. You know, it's everything about leading by example. And the practice company, definitely doing the practice company, was always rah rah rah, different talks, you know, motivation. But it was never how to's. So I was always in the environment where, you know, I was always money conscious because I was used to making money from, you know, the marketing, selling newspapers, but I was burnt out. I didn't want to be a producer. I wanted to be a builder. I wanted to see that dream, that vision that they sold. And immediately when I came here, you know, you flew out right after Christmas, you know, just, and that was a big deal to me. That was a big deal, you know, right after Christmas. You didn't have to do that from your family. You poured into us for hours and hours and hours at a time. And I was like, you know, if he's going to lead, I want to be behind somebody that's going to lead by example, where I can definitely follow and build.
Yeah.
So it made sense. I mean, it definitely makes sense.
Your business now covers multiple states. Where you now have office and presences in which states?
So right now we have presence in Nashville. We have presence in Ohio. We have in Arkansas. We have presence in Atlanta, the Atlanta area, very saturated in Memphis, and is growing like very heavily in every other state.
So Ed, growing up in South Central LA, okay, what was your current understanding and programming and mindset when it came to money?
It's funny you ask. That was a conversation that we never talked about. It was always, you know, sports. Go play sports. You know, I hop off the bus, you know, coming from school, immediately run into granny house so I can herp and change so I won't be late. My uncle picked me up, and all our focus was sports. Nothing about finances. Nothing about how money works. It was just, I saw a lot of stuff on television and I saw that life, but I never knew the how-tos at all. So never had that language at all.
At all. And then we had a conversation.
Nothing.
Who were the people that kids in the neighborhood looked up to in South Central? They were making money.
So in my room, we had a lot of people that were selling drugs. We saw the fancy cars, the loud music. But for me is, you know, the athletes. I saw athletes on TV because that's what I wanted to be. I love Bo Jackson. Bo Jackson, all he can be. So I looked up to a lot because I wanted to be an athlete. I wanted to be a professional player. But a lot of times I saw a lot of people around the neighborhood that made money. I was, you know, doing entrepreneurship, selling drugs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I was talking to Chris earlier, and I was asking him about the role and responsibility of fatherhood today.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and of course you know, had your relationship with your dad and now you have a family, you have a blended family, and now you got, you know, Ace, too, as well,
yeah.
Which I call the bridge kid. She would call that the bridge kid, like kind of brings everybody together.
Absolutely.
We have, you know, Sheen and I, we have Jordan. So, what's your take on men today in America and what's their role?
We have so many bad examples when it comes to the African-American community. You know, I feel that the reason why I'm in a position of how I treat my kids is because I don't want to do what my father did. He was definitely absent inside the home, going to prison and out of prison. So I was raised by my mom. And I knew that I wanted a father in my life, but at the same time, I saw my mom go through different relationships. So I didn't understand stability at all. So role today is this, and a lot of, we have no example. A lot of the kids are being raised by single moms. And I didn't want to have that for my son. I wanted to be there, make sure that not only do I show him the responsibilities of a man, but showing him love, compassion, knowing that I love him, I care about them, embracing him, hearing his voice and spending time with him, because that was a lot of things that I was missing as a young kid.
Yeah.
You know, my father was absent, you know, and when I did things wrong, it was, I didn't have a voice where I can explain to my mom. It was, go get the switch. My mom said, go get the belt. It was hard discipline.
Wow, gotcha.
You know, and so I learned how to be a father based on the examples that I didn't want to be a part of being raised as a young youth when I was little.
Gotcha. And now you're coaching and mentoring and helping people, and much like yourself, they're not coming from the financial services industry. Mm-hmm. You know, what areas are you seeing and identifying in the people that you're recruiting, training, and developing when they come into this type of platform, when they come into this type of environment? What are you seeing from the people out there, especially when it's coming through this pandemic, these lockdowns, these mandates? You know, what has been your experience thus far in helping and recruiting and training people?
Man, that's a good question. I'm glad you asked a good question. I see a lot of people just need help. They need help. You know, different up and downs what's going on with the pandemic. A lot of people losing jobs. You know, a lot of people making more money than just unemployment.
Yeah.
So having a conversation in my city, in my state, Memphis, is just more of trust.
Yeah.
You know, they need to feel like they have an environment where somebody's going to take care of them. They're going to feel trust. They can trust the environment. Someone's going to protect them. And they have the ability to make income too, as well. But a lot of times, you know, when they start working with us, we build the relationship first. The most important thing is building the trust. You know, they don't want to move until they know that they can trust us. And it's not something that's going to be an in and out of game. And it's going to be something long term. You know, that's the biggest thing, especially through this pandemic.
Yep.
You know, we were able to flow through the pandemic, recession proof. That's where we made our strongest income through the pandemic. So a lot of people are just looking for more security, where they can actually lay their head at night and knowing that they're going to make income and something's going to be there and the pandemic is not going to take it away.
You know, in your city, at the recording of this video, sadly, a tragedy in your city. And, you know, a young rapper named Young Dolph just got his house broken into. They murdered him in his house. And he was a respected musician, artist, you know, as a guy in the community, that's got to affect you. You got to wonder what the heck's going on. And how do you respond to something like that? As a member of the Black community, as a member of, and a citizen of Memphis.
It's funny you say that. And Jimmy and I were talking about that because it happened when we actually were hopping on the airplane when we were going to Dallas.
Wow.
And it's like a crab in a bucket mentality. You know, anytime someone's doing good, they feel, you know, hatred, or they want to, you know, kill him because he's doing better than them. I feel that we need to unite. It's hard in our community where a lot of us get along. And we listen, you know, it can be someone in our community that has no money, no savings at all. And you can be that mentor and their blessing. Mm-hmm. And they still won't listen at times because of how he was raised and the pride that we want to have. To answer to your question, what I'll say is that we just need to come together, stop the violence and unite. You know, from back in the days with the Martin Luther King, you know, I have a dream.
Yeah.
Always was like, we need to come together. We need to come together. We need to come together. And it's just time for us to unite and stop the violence and come together and trust each other so we can grow an empire. Because if this doesn't stop, it's gonna be a crap in a bucket mentality all the time.
Yep.
And it's never gonna change. But it starts with our young generation, raising the kids in the households, because a lot of times these individuals that's doing all this gang violence, they don't have any father in the home. They're raised by their mom. And their mom is not putting their foot down. They're letting them come in and out, you know, how they please. So they're the men of the house at 12 or 13 years old. So they don't know what is the responsibility of a man. So that's one of the main things that I pride myself in, being a strong father, because that's what's killing our community today.
Yeah. When you're talking about personal finance, financial services in the Black community, in the Latino community, because your office is pretty diversified too as well. You've got Black, Brown, White, you get the whole thing. Now, when you're looking at teaching people about personal finance in an area, in a community, and by the way, Memphis is one of the homes of one of the oldest life insurance company, one of the oldest Black-owned insurance company, which is Universal Life Insurance Company, which is now owned by a North Carolina insurance company. But Memphis was a pretty predominant place for life insurance back in the day. So how are you educating families on basic personal finance, insurance 101?
We're just educating them on just the basics of how money grows. You know, my thing is, a lot of individuals, all we know is the basics. What is a 401k, 403, check and savings account? And a lot of families don't understand how money grows. So the first piece is just showing them how it grows. And then when it comes to generational wealth and having a lot of money packed away for your retirement, you want to keep a lot of the money. So a lot of times we educate people on how they get taxed too as well. So tax now, tax later, tax free, and give them the education piece of what products do and how can they access the products, maximizing their potential so they can pull home all the money that they didn't save it up for 40, 50 years, pull home the max.
Yeah.
So that's how we educate them in the community.
Now, you were mentioning earlier that you've made the most amount of income to and through this pandemic.
Absolutely.
So a lot of people are wanting to work from home, but you just mentioned it to me right before this interview began, you're looking at bigger office space. Mm-hmm. So talk to me about that.
We just locked in a big office.
We did.
In Cairoville. Yeah. Cairoville off of Forrester Irene, 5,000 square feet.
Nice.
And great deal now. We're pivoting face-to-face. Pandemic was, you know, going through the pandemic, going through Zoom, it was good. It took our business, it scaled our business. We went from having, you know, roughly 20 agents, you know, on and off coming to the office to scaling it to about 90 to 100 people on Zoom.
Yeah.
But I wasn't getting the feel that we needed, you know, so getting that feel, that energy, that culture.
Like so in person, though, in person feel.
That we needed. So now we're going to pivot. The income is, we went from 135,000 when we first
started during the pandemic,
and all the way to 387,000.
You're at 387 right now.
387 right now.
Cash flow.
So we shy about 120 grand away from half a million.
How's that? Does it go a long way in Memphis?
Yeah, definitely. Goes a long way. And what I love about it, though, with PHP is not only am I making great money, but I'm learning what to do with it. With my previous career, I wasn't educated about finances.
Yeah.
So with the money, six figures we were making, it came in and went right out.
Yep.
So not only do you get ability to make a lot of money with a recession-proof business, you have the ability to know where to put it at so it can grow for you and your family.
Now, people might say, well, you know, Ed, you know, you did have a little bit of a business background. You knew how to sell newspapers. Mm-hmm. Is this something where a person like myself came from the military, or somebody comes from the post office, somebody comes from construction, somebody comes working for FedEx or Kellogg because they're big employers in your city. Mm-hmm. Is this something that they can do, and can you teach them to get fairly successful in this business too as well?
Absolutely. I mean, with your income and always grow, go with your self-development. So even though I was in sales before, the biggest challenge, I wasn't reading. I wasn't self-development. So my income wasn't moving. It was always staying stagnant. So the beauty about, you know, coming here to PHP is more the leadership roles, you know, identifying your leaks and different books that you read. You know, building your identity.
Mm-hmm.
So because your identity is a strong reflection from your income.
Yeah.
You know, the higher your identity go, the more your income increases.
Yeah.
And what I love about it, though, is definitely duplicatable. It's definitely because you can pour that into your guys from what you're self-developing on, what you're reading, and then leading by example, the income would definitely increase in general by helping families and educating them how money grows. Definitely.
I didn't ask this to Chris, but I want to ask you this question, though. How is it like working together with husband and wife, with Jamie? Because I know Jamie's a strong personality as
very
well.
Strong.
And she's a ball. You know, she's like Sheena.
Yeah. Very strong. that's a good question. That's definitely a good question. But, you know, at the beginning, we back and forth, you know, bullheaded. But
it's conflict. It's conflict, yeah.
Both conflict going back in, because, you know, she have her way, I have my way.
Yeah.
But from your leadership, you mentioned the leadership, not judging anyone at all, just talking to us about your personal experiences. Yeah. Now we understand, you know, what lines to cross and what lines not to cross. But it was definitely a challenge.
Yeah.
But I believe it made us stronger, though. It made us come closer as a family.
Yeah.
It made us put ourselves in a position of what we want for our kids and how we want our kids to grow up.
Yeah.
You know, and that's what a family need. They need that strong background.
Yeah.
You know, a divorce is never an option. I learned that from you all the way.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you know, another thing I learned from you is just how to take front and being the man, you know, leading by example. Because a lot of times these marriages, their wife is leading. Oh, you know, a happy wife is a happy life. You remember that saying?
You're right.
You know, they always say that. But at the same time, a woman wants a strong leader. That's going to give them, you know, stability where they feel that they're going to be protected. And that's what this environment gives me, with a strong leadership and just leading by example.
Yeah, that's powerful. Is there like a personality type, or is there a certain type of person that you said, okay, they are really predisposed to entrepreneurship, they are predisposed to be in the financial services industry? If you could put somebody as a target type of personality that would do really well at this, because like I mentioned before, a lot of people that we tend to attract don't come from financial services.
Right. Just ordinary, or ordinary average people that wants to compete. Someone that wants to compete, that dare to be different. Someone that dare to be different, that, you know, someone that want to be, you know, great for their family. You know, we don't judge anyone here. You know, we don't care, you know, you white, black, pink, orange, green, you know, long as you have a heart and a desire to win. You know, for your family, for your community, that's all we care about. We are teaching the rest.
Yeah. Cool. So as we wrap up this, any final thoughts here? For somebody watching this video, is there anything on your heart, your spirit that you want to say, hey, man, listen, you know, let's play financial offense during this pandemic. Let's play financial offense regardless of lockdowns and mandates and vax, no vax, all this stuff that people are going through, Republican, Democrat, White House, all this stuff, that the craziness that seems to charge everybody on social media and mainstream media. What guidance and advice would you give to the person watching this video right now to start making a financial change in your life and making sure that they're taking the steps necessary, then next year coming up becomes the best year of their financial life?
It's a lot of stuff going on right now with the pandemic, about, you know, COVID, you know, forcing to take shots, different states, making it a mandate to go to different restaurants, you know. The biggest thing of how we're able to take control of that situation is taking control of your finances. That's the biggest thing. And a lot of people, they don't have hope right now. They got these jobs that's not secure. They're getting laid off, or they're getting closed down because COVID reasons. Yeah. The biggest thing that I tell them, there's hope around the corner.
Yeah.
You know, we're here. We're here to stay. We're here to grow. We're here to change, you know, what's going on with America. But the first thing starts with raising up your personal standards, raising up your income.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what PHP did for me. Not only did it make me a strong leader, you know, I'm in a position where I can do whatever the hell I want to.
Yeah.
No one's thumb is over my head.
Yeah.
I'm in control of my income. If my income falls, that's because of me, not because of the company.
Yeah.
You know, if I wanted to defend my family, or if I wanted to protect my family through this COVID, I raise up my income. So the biggest thing I tell anyone that's struggling right now is just make a financial decision and do something better. But it starts with self. You know, you can't focus on, you know, anyone else until you look in the mirror and you realize who needs to change and the opportunity in front of you. We're in the number one industry. Financial services right behind your LeBron James. You know, we're in the number one industry that control. The biggest thing is we're here.
Yeah.
You know, we reach out to you, reach out to us, and We'll definitely help you out, because we're looking for an army so we can stop these bullies from bullying individuals and forcing them to do things.
I'm just curious, from you growing up, has any of your views changed, your mindsets changed, your perspectives changed from how you see the world? Because, you know, when I started, you know, serving the military, I started voting myself. It's like, hey, guys, how do we vote? And I remember my Marines were saying, hey, everybody in the military votes Republican. I'm like, why? I don't know. Were there any stereotypes like that you started to unpack and uncover and demystify why certain views are handed down to you, why certain people should vote a certain way? Because I think more and more now that we're seeing, the more involved we get in our local governments and create the economic policies to make us be more financially free and say, hey, government, get out of our way. Let us be Edward and Jamie Musgrove making $387 a year, $400,000 a year, $500,000 a year, $1 million a year. Has any of that changed in your time here at PHP?
Big time.
Really?
When I was growing up, all I thought about is being a Democrat. That's what my grandmother preached. That's what my mom preached. And it was all African-American black people are Democrats, you know. But coming from PHP and understanding, you know, what politics is all about, you know, Republican side or what the Democratic side is, you know, definitely. I wouldn't say that I'm a Democrat. I wouldn't say that I'm a Republican. Mm-hmm. But I know for sure, though, I'll be an independent. You know, I'll be an independent, you know, just knowing more importantly is capitalism is the most important thing.
Yeah.
That's the most powerful thing, you know, having the opportunity to dictate your life.
Because capitalism gets bastardized a lot. You know, rich people are jerks. Absolutely. Well, don't you want to be rich too? I think, quite frankly, you're a rich guy.
Yeah.
You were that broke guy at one point in South Central LA. Now you make him $387 in Compton. You're that rich guy now. So you care about that type of stuff.
Well, and that's the beauty about PHP, your leadership. I mean, you're a cash millionaire, right? You constantly pouring into us. You constantly leading by example, giving hope. When you're in Watts and you're in South Central LA, you're not around that type of environment. So you constantly looking at other people like, how can I get it? Who am I going to steal rod from? You know, how can I get how can I make $387,000 a year? Damn sure it's not insurance. They're not thinking about it. So the most important thing is getting out of your environment and not letting anyone control your mindset. Because it comes from high school. It comes from elementary that they're brainwashing these kids in these small communities and talking about Democrat and Republican. And it's a constant cycle. They start our parents, when our parents were younger, they raised up to have that same mindset. And then our parents pour it into us.
Yeah.
And how we break that is understanding, you know, what is America about? You know, it's about freedom, you know, dreaming, you know, the land of the brave. You know, now I'm pouring that into my kids. I'm pouring that into my son. He's in high school right now, 15 years old. My daughter, she's 14. She's a freshman in high school. And then I have a young, you know, 3-year-old, you know, pouring into them so they know how to vote. They know, they understanding what's going on in America. They understanding, you know, the importance of entrepreneurship and capitalism. But it all starts off from the home.
Yep.
So, because my mindset was, you know, rich or rich, we're going to be poor. You know, they're spoiled. Their parents gave them the money. I never had the mindset as younger that someone was able to, you know, find an opportunity like PHP and run up the ladder and make income to change the generational life for their family forever.
And if that's something you want to do too as well, make sure you follow Edward Musgrove, his wife, Jamie Musgrove, on Instagram and Facebook. We'll put all the links here in the lower third of this video, as well as the description at the bottom. And I'd love to know your thoughts, your comments, and what this gentleman is doing and experiencing in his neck of the town. If there's something you want to step up to the plate and do some yourself, hey, send us a comment, direct message, Edward Musgrove here, about your thoughts and take a step forward in faith. That being said, guys, if you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page, Money Smart Guy. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click like, hit subscribe, and hit notifications. Be alerted the next time. To be alerted the next time we upload our next episode. In Columbia, Maryland, where we're at right now, on behalf of Edward Musgrove, I'm your Money Smart Guy. And until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to live smart, and be money smart today. Bye-bye, guys.